How old were you when you got your first boob implant?
21. I was 21 for my first one, 26, I think, for my second.
You got a second one. Why'd you get a second one?
Well, because the first one weren't big enough.
And why'd you have a third one?
The third one was because they still weren't big enough.
Okay.
And the second set was leaking after I nursed my children.
Okay. And you can nurse children with breast implants?
Yeah, girl. You can do anything with breast implants.
Yeah. And now, fast forward all these years later, you have changed yourself one more time.
For good. This time for good, yeah. I went through the journey. So you said my first breast implant surgery, I was 21 years old. And I did it for a multitude of reasons, mostly because growing up, I was the girl who, you know, the boys would pick on me.
Yeah.
To be honest, because I had nothing. I always had this, so I knew to walk in backwards.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't have this, and I felt incomplete. My dad subscribed to Playboy. I grew up looking at all these magazines and thinking, when is my turn? Well, my turn never came until I saw the doctor.
Uh-huh.
Self-esteem is what I was looking for. You know, I knew that I had personality. I knew I had all these things, but this was always something that meant something to me.
Yeah.
And then I had my kids and my husband, and then... they started leaking, set number two, after I nursed them. So I knew it. You couldn't really see it, but I could kind of tell. And I went to the last surgeon, and he said, not only were you right, they were leaking, but it was kind of starting to get bad.
Yeah, I know, because you were saying that you had a suspicion that that had some, it was somehow maybe linked to your thyroid condition.
So my thyroid condition happened about 4 years after my first set of implants. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know I had something called Hashimoto's. And that went on for years with all these symptoms, a regular heartbeat, hair loss, dry skin, chronic fatigue to the point where I couldn't even stay awake. And it was really, really debilitating.
Yeah.
All linked to the thyroid. And I couldn't regulate it. I couldn't get it right. To the point where I got when I was trying to get pregnant, I wasn't getting pregnant.
And doctors haven't made that link, really, that breast implants could lead to Hashimoto's or
thyroid.
Well,
the smart doctors have, you see. There's a whole bunch of women that have been affected by breast implant illness. So when I put it all together, I realized, oh, so I have an autoimmune condition, Hashimoto's, and the one thing that my body's fighting every single day of my life for 24 hours a day is this invader called breast implants. Now, I still love plastic surgery.
Yes.
And this will not happen to everybody.
That's right.
But this is my story, and there's a movement of hundreds of thousands of women that have the same story as I do, whether it's not Hashimoto's, but it could be, you know, lupus or some other kind of autoimmune disorder. And a lot of them are connected to breast implants and breast implant illness.
So you made a big decision.
So I made a big decision to book an appointment with a great explant surgeon who took out the breast implant and the capsule. I had full breast reconstruction. I am now an A cup, like, and really happy for the first time
too.
In my life. We're both the same
size. I'm an A cup too.
We're the same size bra.
Yeah.
But for me, it was, my breast implants were a big part of my identity.
Yeah.
I showed them off. I loved them. Again, I pull whatever I can now and still try to make it happen. It's just not happening. And I love them and I celebrate them. I love a caricature. And that's kind of what they were to me, but it was time to say goodbye.
Yeah, and you have a new documentary that you're working on about the whole experience.
Yeah.
And there are lots of women who most women have successful breast implants. In your case, you felt that it was something you needed to change.
Yes, there are a majority of women that are fine with them, but there are symptoms you could look out for, and there are certainly organizations such as healingbreastimplantillness.com.
Wait, that's a mouthful. What's it called?
Healing.
Yeah.
Breast Implant Illness.
Okay.
.com.
That's a long name, isn't
Not
it?
Not that long.
Yeah. Okay.
There's a Facebook group for it. But if you're thinking, oh my goodness, this is what's happening to me, you could log on there and see if any of your symptoms match up. Because the good thing is the FDA just had a meeting and they decided not to ban breast implants at this time because there is a cancer specifically related to textured breast implants.
Mm.
But what they did do was quietly released information saying that they are going to now make it mandatory that women find out what is in the contents of the breast implants. Because it's not just what they're filled with, it's the outside, it's the actual shell that is causing the problems. And we didn't know the things that were in them, like formaldehyde is in our body. So yeah, there are things that we need to know. And now it's gonna be mandatory that women at least are informed with what they're putting in. Because at 21, I still would have said, yep, please, I'm gonna sign here. I want that in my body.
Yeah.
Just
well,
know.
Well, you've seen my breasts.
Yes.
Yeah. Those are two tube socks tied up really tight in a push-up bra. And I have some big old
bazoombas. Yes, you do. Yes.